Greetings, fellow Oathlings. Welcome back to some more Elder Scrolls Arena. The task at hand today is to travel all the way over to Valenwood in search of, clues to the next piece of the Staff of Chaos. Now, I'm not really all that well brushed up on my lore, so I don't really know which faction of people that Valenwood belongs to, but I guess we'll just find out when we get there, right? So, I guess we'll just go to Valenesti? I mean, I've heard of the place. Let's travel. Of course it's night. Spines of the dragon's teeth. Since it is night, we shall be equipping a sword, because we do not want to be... I was expecting this. You have survived the test most dire. Continue along this path, however, and you will face such things as to make your very heart freeze. I will save you the ordeal for my servants approach you even now. From my mangled corpse, I will take what is mine. From your mangled corpse. Okay, so what did you send this time, and where is it? That sounds like a... something. But where is it? Is what I want to know. Man, look at this, yeah, I can't see it. Where is it? Was that supposed to be a... hound of sorts? I don't know. I mean, I could see nothing and it vanished before it ever attacked me, but just look at this artwork. It looks so high res, man. Not just high res, I mean, it's definitely not high res, but it looks amazing. Yeah, alright, right here. Two Minotaurs, which have got nothing usable and were mostly a waste of time, but hey, I'm glad you came along. Give me a chance to swing my sword. So let's go in there, I guess. The Rusty Eagle. On this cool autumn night, the Rusty Eagle seems special, inviting to smell apples baking in the kitchen and look forward to your first draught of ale. Sheathe the sword, walk up straight to the counter, and what's the time right now? 7:12. Okay, we can rest for 11 hours. So cool. Just one day, please. Alright, fine, I've got enough food. And we'll purchase a gin and tonic, because why not? I mean, we are an idiot, so... Alright, so we'll just... nah, not here, not out in public. We'll pretend to be the sleeping bartender, and camp for 11 hours, so that we can wake up in the morning and ask people where exactly it is that we have to go. You know, investigate. Move, please. Can you like, not pap in my face the next time around, please? Thank you. Like, I know my face is attractive, but, dude, come on. You need to have a little bit of decency, right? So where is... out with it, Elden Grove. There has been strange talk of Elden Grove being near Eldenroot. If the rumors are true, you may want to start searching there. Okay, so... travel to Eldenroot in Valenwood. And Eldenroot would be... where is it? Where is it? Where is it? Ah, right here. Ooh, let's go. Ah, it's morning for a change. Okay. City of Eldenroot in Valenwood Province. Lodas, 19th of Hearthfire, 3rd Era 389. It took 9 days to reach your goal. You enter Eldenroot, Wood Elven City, near the center of Valenwood. Bosma territory, I see. The elves here seem friendly and you are hailed and welcome. You overhear that the city-state's commerce is going well. So if you ever read the in-game book A Dance in Fire, you'll soon realize that, the Bosmer, they actually don't live in, like, constructed houses and stuff like this. They actually live in places where, you know, they're more natural with their approach. But I like the fact that this guy actually has got like a distinctly different appearance. Let's just take a look at this guy's, you know, like clothes and his hair. It isn't the same as the ones which we saw up north in High Rock and Skyrim, and definitely not the same as the ones which we saw in Hammerfell. But the appearance of the women seems to be stay relatively the same. But anyway, yeah, let's just ask him where Elden Grove is. You know of the legendary Elden Grove. Take your question to the palace. The queen will perhaps be able to help you on your quest. And where would the queen be? It's east of here. Yeah, so I mean, the Bosmer, if you read the book A Dance in Fire, I mean, it's a good story. You should read it even if you're like not interested in the Elder Scrolls lore. I think they're like 2 to 3 short chapters to it, but yeah, it's the story is actually quite good, so I would definitely recommend giving it a read. And yeah, so in that book they've described how they actually live either in the forest or on actual trees that move around. Am I going the right way? I don't know. Might as well ask this Chester then. Yeah, and they've actually done a good job of describing the cities pretty well, like, oh yeah, right here. North of here, huh? It is strange that, the palace... Oh, come on, bugger. The palace isn't, right on, like, the city walls, but, yeah, oh well. I wanted to visit east and I ended up going south. Huh. It is unusually warm for the autumn in Eldenroot, but the audience chamber of Queen Ulandra reflects little of the sunshine outside. Not how they described it, but fine. And the queen looks quite generic. Anyway. You ask us for the location of the Eldenroot, birthplace of the sacred post tree. Such knowledge has a price. Obviously it does. Over the past year, we have seen a beautiful Valenwood change. Parts have become unsafe for travelers. Others have turned dark and sinister, leeching the very... What's that? Earth blood from the soil. Elerion, greatest of our low masters, found bodies of our people sucked dry of all fluid. Sounds scary and pleasurable at the same time. They lay wasted, living dead that had no memories of their former existence. Zombies, I see. Sadly, they had to be destroyed. 10 of our rangers left to search through the Valenwood forests, hoping for a clue to this mystery. 2 months later, the severed heads were delivered to us by an emissary of someone who calls herself Selene, High Priestess of Shagrath, the god of spiders. Okay. You sure that's not Shagrath? But then again, he's the god of insanity and creativity, not spiders, so let's see. She delivered to us an ultimatum. Surrender Valenwood or die. We are not a fighting people and have no standing army. We prefer to dwell here amongst the trees and Mother Earth, rejoicing in the commune of the land. We cannot stand against Selene and her spider warriors. I fear an end to my people and our way of life. You seem to be a strong and formidable adventurer. I implore you, put an end to her. Wow, this is 3 entire pages, huh? Threat against us. I will inscribe on your map the location of her emissary, referred to as Selene's Web. Okay. Site of her supposed surrender? Somewhere in those dark corridors lies the one thing that can safeguard us from her greed. Somewhere in the fortress lies her heart. It is said to be a great jewel into which she has infused her life force. If you bring us this jewel, she will dare not attack us with her life in the balance. If you are successful, we will share with you the secret knowledge of the Elden Grove. Will you help us? I don't really think I've got much of a choice here, do I? Sure. You are truly a compassionate soul. No, not really. I just wanna get the pieces of the Elder Scroll. Sorry, the pieces of the Staff of Chaos. Know this. Selene's web lies near the city of Eldenroot. I pray, be careful. She's a powerful sorceress who consorts with the undead. I wish thee luck on thy quest. Queen Ulandra inscribes the location of Selene's Feb onto your map. I guess that's our next adventure. Selene's Web, wherever that is. Yeah, right here. That seems quite close. One day's to travel, see? 80 kilometers, so. I mean, for a game made in the USA, they sure did make sure to follow the metric system. This dank, moldy corridor leads into Selene's Web. The smell of wet air, wet earth, lingers in the air. That's good. That sounds quite good. And I guess this is one of those resting places, no? Yes. No. I don't know. I mean, this seems to be leading somewhere. I guess we'll check that out in due time. And I can no longer hear the... I still can. Scratch that. So I'll just mark this as the exit. I mean, I didn't exactly need to mark it now that I know that you can, you know, like, scroll the map, but I still did. Alright. And we have a wolf. Nothing usable, doesn't hurt to check, to be honest. So, I mean, should I check the rooms while I'm at it? I mean, I don't... There doesn't really seem to be much of a reason to not do so. Oh, really? Come on. I have to tell you, I mean, the speed boost, it gives me, like, it makes playing the game so much easier because everything's faster now, but that also has the downside of, you know, enemies' attacks being faster, and you need to, like, faster fingers and faster reflex times to actually survive now. So yeah, I guess that's one of the downsides. I'll just save here just in case. I don't want to like exploit the save options, but I mean, but just in case, because I didn't exactly save after reading all that text, and I'm actually quite lazy to like do that again in case I die, so I'll just save here just in case. The enemies here are I see that they're much easier, to be honest. And nothing here. So this actually seems more like a corridor than anything else. So 3 dead spiders in a row. That was an ominous sound. But yeah, I mean, so... more spiders. The enemies in this section are, like, quite easy. They're nothing too difficult. For example, right now I'm barely breaking a sweat playing this. I mean, the only potion I've had to use thus far was the potion of, you know, free action and nothing else. So, I mean... Wait, didn't I already kill you? Time to... So, see, after so many enemies, I've, like, faced so many enemies, and this is the first time that I am using a potion of healing. Not even a potion of healing, I'm just using my ring of healing, so... Yeah, that's, I suppose you could say that that's, like, that makes the game a little... This level is a little easier compared to the previous level. Labyrinthian, but hey, who knows, right? And this place has nothing. As I doubted that it would. Wolfy chance. Another thing about this game is that it does not follow the... Oh shit, ghouls. These guys are always a tough fight. Competitively, I mean, not really as tough as they used to be. Ooh, I got a level of experience. I'm now level 13. Yay, my favorite number, my lucky number. So, what do I want to pour all of my experience into? I guess willpower? And yeah, I'll just hold off on the luck for now. Because it is already 60 points. What? Should I get it to 62 points? I don't really know. I'll just pour one more into willpower and one more into my luck. So yeah, we're done with that. And I'll just use my ring of healing again. And I guess we're good to go. So we are here. There's nothing else here really. We can get out here and yeah, that's that. So back into the exploration of the cave. Not the cave, sorry. Rather the dungeon, I guess? I mean, this is a dungeon crawler and this looks like a dungeon. Seriously, the spider gave me 35 gold pieces? That was so generous of him. I mean, where was the spider hiding it? Why did it have 35 gold pieces on it in the first place? Ah, Skelly. I mean, I could pull my mace out. I mean, that's pretty much the only reason I bought the mace, but yeah, it doesn't really, you know, seem like a necessity to me at this point. I'll stop using the Ring of Healing and I'll start using the Potions of Heal True more, because I want to save the Ring of Healing for later when I would actually require it. And two wolves. Seems like a pretty good place, I guess. I'll just mark this area as cool, you know, for recreation. For when you're not killing monsters. And this is, I guess this is one of those resting places. Is it though? I don't know, man. I mean, I really don't know. So yeah, as I was saying, this game has got like a not a contact-based hit system, but rather a chance-based hit system. So as long as you're within the designated amount of tiles, which is like I think 2 or 3 tiles of length, you will catch your opponent even though you're not making contact with them. So yeah, so just a means of saying that, you know, like, you can't, fleeing isn't really all that easy in this game unless you've got like a ton of speed. So okay, so adamantium belt unequip. Ooh, this is much better. I'll be equipping this and I shall be selling the adamantium belt. So onwards, unto darkness, because darkness is pretty much the only place to go now. Okay, so let me make you a deal here. I use the mark of shocking on you. Okay, I can't. Alright, no problem. Yeah, I'll just go the long way around, no problem. I guess I need to be in like melee range to use the mark of shocking. So yeah, that's something. I mean, if these staffs were enchanted, I might as well have taken them, but then again, I mean, staffs themselves don't really fetch you a lot of money, so I honestly don't want to waste a lot of inventory space, valuable, useful inventory space on staffs, enchanted or not. So yeah, there we go. Yeah, I just returned from here. Okay, that was a little eerie, I have to admit. And now we are in the dark corners of the dungeon, from which there are no escape. I'm just kidding, I mean, there's always an escape. I just hope I didn't, like, take the wrong turn at the very beginning and end up somewhere, you know, that I'm not supposed to go. Because that would actually suck. I would have to, like, explore all of the dungeon and then, like, head all the way back to the beginning just so that I end up where I'm supposed to go. So, yeah. Let's hope that is not the case, but even if it is, it just means longer videos and, yeah. More of an annoyance for you guys. I mean, if I deal with it, you have to deal with it as well. No way around it. We're in this together. So I say to the 17 subscribers that I have, none of whom watch my videos, so... Yeah. Just in case I get a few subscribers in the future, and decide to keep this thing going. And this area is a dead end, so... This place looks a little special. I mean, what is this? Is that like a magical wall or something? Ooh, yellow walls. What was that? Hold up, I'm just marking this place as yellow room. And, yeah. I'm gonna save quickly in case I die to whatever that was. And I'm gonna continue on my way. That certainly sounds like something, alright. Like somebody chucking spells at me. At least fireballs. I can't really tell what exactly that was, but that was something. Oh, it was a ghost. Alright. I mean, it's... You don't really get to hear... attack sounds all that often for some reason, probably because, you know, they probably use like one audio channel and how gentle of you, how polite of you to open the door for me, and as a reward you get to die. One more. Is this door open or is it closed? It's open. All right. More spiders? Just how many spiders are there? Huh. So the only reason I'm actually increasing my willpower is because it makes me more immune to getting paralyzed by... You know? Paralyzed or getting... under the influence of spells that I'm not supposed to be getting under the influence of. Another spider? Where do you guys keep crawling out from? Like, seriously. Have you ever thought of people who are arachnophobic? Or is that the point? I'm guessing that's the entire point, to be honest. But, you never know. Wait, does this lead somewhere? No, it does not. Where do we go? Where have we come? Ah, we're heading back towards the exit. How convenient. I mean, we haven't visited this place, so we might as well try, right? Head back, take a left, take a right. Cool. And who dares attack me? Nobody? Alright, not a problem by me. I mean, I'm fine with it. Okay, so where to now? We can try this place, or we can just, you know, try going in through this door here. If there is anything here. Nothing? Cool. So I guess I'll just try... And this door leads us nowhere. Huh. Curious. I guess we could try using this pathway right here. If that is at all a pathway, and... Oh yes, it is. Oddly, this small passage bears marks of heavy use. I guess I'm going the right way then. I suppose. Another ghoul? Is that two ghouls? No, just one. I guess I wasn't really able to see the ghoul the first time around because it was so dark in that room. 50 ghoul pieces, let's go. I'm so glad I came here. Save time. That sounded like something. That was definitely something. And we are here at a crossroads. Oh, look at that! We're at the right place. I'm just gonna go quickly explore this place once before I get over here. So, yeah. An Orsimer! How are you, brother? Good? No? Dead? Good. Dead Orsimer is a good Orsimer. Not really. Come on. I'm just messing with you. You guys matter. A ring! Amazing. I know what that does, but I'm grateful for it. Thank you. Thank you for giving me your ring. I mean, not like you did have, like, not like you had much of a choice, but yeah, you get the point. So I shall take the left road. You see a door with a golden lock. Oh really, come on, I need to... Huh. Deeper. So basically I need to scour the entire dungeon for a golden key now. Okay, I mean, if that's the way you guys want to play it, let's go, I guess. I'm just wishing that I did not miss the key anywhere, because if I did, that would suck. So, yeah. So, I guess the only place we haven't looked yet is some place here and here. So we go back out and take this road. That is a dead end. I just realized I would actually suck at navigating through mazes and stuff in real life. Huh. Something to chew on, I guess. We've already been here, so... curious. Another yellow room, perhaps? Meeting dense, no light or noise. Ha. Ha 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 ha. Meeting dense, let's go. I mean, I might want to save here, you know, since this is like a meeting den and all. Really? Hey, I'm not paralyzed. That's cool. That's cool. I wasn't paralyzed for too long. And I guess that's just the effect of willpower. It makes sure that you keep paralyzed for a lesser amount of time. And yeah, I can't go through there, so I guess I'll just climb back up here. So a lot of this game is actually like moving around without purpose and mapping the entire place up. And if you stumble upon where you want to go, that's cool. If you don't, then you will eventually. And katana. Do I want the katana? Is it enchanted? No, it is not. Time to drop it. And I think I got a ring? No, a dog. Adamantium dog. Excuse me. This is a much better dog. Yep, I'm so wearing this. I'm glad I came here because... I mean, right now I've got like so much better loot. So yeah, so that's that. I got some gold and a torque. I shall save here because I got a better torque and I've got like a better... So basically this is where they breed the spiders then. Yeah, so I got a better torque and I got a better... What would you like to call it? And this is some gold lying here? 30 gold pieces, let's go. So yeah, basically I got better talk and a better... Huh. So I forgot to loot it the first time around. We can try going here, I suppose. And I think the other thing was an amulet, I suppose. Or I forgot what it was. I got something else which was amazing. So yeah. Really? Are you gonna heal through and reaction? It's strange because I was paralyzed for a longer time this time around. And I guess this is the main area of the breeding pits, so... Ooh, more gold. Look at that. Braces, buckler, longsword. Is any of this enchanted, is the question. The buckler is not. Is the longsword? Yes, it is. And what about the braces? Braces of visit log. Hey, I could have used the braces of visit log. Oh, damn, I didn't think about that. Alright, fine. We'll just search for the gold key, and if we can't find it, we'll use the braces of visit log then. Just for the sake of convenience. And there is nothing else here. So, that was that for this section, and I guess the only place really left to go is this area here, like straight, so let's hit it. And this would be the pool area, this would be a door, which we have probably already come through because it looks like it has been cleared. And really? The spider has been blocking my attacks using water, I wonder. Ox, you gotta love them, man. I mean, what's your favorite race in the Elder Scrolls series? I know, I mean, I don't have any subscribers and I'm just asking this question as a pointless exercise, which is not going to bear any fruit, but yeah. As if I'm ever gonna have any subscribers, but yeah, what's your favorite race in the Elder Scrolls series? I would love to know about you guys, all 17 of you. Is that what it said? Like, ah? I'll just save here, I guess, just in case. Huh. E to E. ~100 gold pieces, that's what I'm talking about. And a longbow, which is hopefully not enchant. So, what does this mean? What is this supposed to mean? A, arrow, 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 A. That didn't do anything. I guess this was an exercise in futility. But on the bright side, we still have this place to go to, so... Yeah, I mean, let's go ahead and check it out. Why not? Plus, we still have some places to explore here, so... I mean, there are a lot of places for answers, so... Yeah, let's go. I guess. Huh, where did I come out? I wanna go straight. Okay. Is there somebody here? Nobody? Let's just use this tunnel just for the shits and giggles. Wait, I can't jump up there? Really? See? I could. See, this time I wasn't paralyzed for so long, so... I mean, sometimes I am, sometimes I'm not. And this seems to be like an entirely new section, so... what do you know? No, it's not. No, it is not. And I thought it was an entirely new section. Where did I come out from, though? Strange. I mean, I jumped through here, right? So I guess we proceed this way? Let's just check this room first, like quickly. And this is time for me to pull out my Dwarven Mace of Shock Resistance. Bum-bum-bum-bum. Mithril Helm, that's gonna sell for quite some money. So, I mean, is this enchanted though? No, not really, but man, that looks good. So yeah, but I'll just still stick to Steel Helm of Speed because, well, it boosts my speed, so... Saber of Agility, let's equip that right back, and... wow, I've got like an extra boost to my AR for some reason. Huh. Curious. I mean, the game does this sometimes, it sort of glitches out in this manner and gives you like an extra boost when it is not supposed to, but I don't really know what's like up with that, so yeah. Anyway, on with the mission. I'll just save here once again. Just in case, you know. You know how it goes. It's the Elder Scrolls Arena. And you never know how shit's gonna go down. I mean, every time you hear that music, it is sort of eerie. It sends this sort of a chill down your spine. And I just jumped because of this ghoul who dropped at my feet to die. Conveniently. Where it is meant to be. Good seeing you. And I'm happy that you died. That place looks like it is open. Before you lies a small arena surrounded by water. Something glitters on the stones of one island. And I'm sort of betting that that is where the key is. Wait, I'll just heal myself first before I go ahead and save. So, yeah. I'll just save it here. And let's go ahead and check this place first. Or not, I mean, this place sort of leads me back to the exit, so... yeah, let's just check this room first. I mean, we're not really in a hurry, are we? Nothing here, except for this... cloth tied to a post, and I can hear some... wolves. Which don't really faze me at this point anymore. And we're back to the very beginning. Should've taken this over and had the chance. See, I told you that I probably missed the mission objective sometime, like somewhere near the beginning of the entrance, like somewhere near the entrance. And there it was, and who took a swipe at me? Who dares take a swipe at me? Could you, like, move and let me move? So many spiders, my god. Well, this guy's dead. And there is nothing here. Like, practically, absolutely nothing. Nada. Yeah, I'll just jump here, quickly get this treasure. And is this short sword enchanted? Yeah, I know that thing is attacking me. I'll just deal with it shortly. Really? I'm paralyzed? Really? At least I'm glad that it's missing all its attacks. I still can't move? Like, seriously? Okay, I'll just use a potion of free action then. Wait, what happened? Why can I still not move? Yeah, I guess I'll just use you, but why can't I still move? Potion of free action. Yeah, I can move now. 70 gold pieces, you've got to be kidding me. Like from that spider? Thank you. So this is the place where we get the key. Right after I kill you guys, so... Nothing usable, nothing usable. I mean, what does a spider do with 70 gold? Is my question. But I guess we don't really need to bother ourselves with that much. Potion of heal, true. Minotaurs just spawned out of nowhere, seriously? And yeah, one behind me as well. I mean, I'm not really scared of you guys, I can take you guys on pretty easily. Minotaurs, what a joke. Is this a steel helm? Probably not, otherwise it would not be a steel helm. Let's see. No, it's not. Drop it. I have to tell you though, I mean, exploring the dungeons is actually so rewarding in this game that... I mean, you can't even call it grinding, because the more you explore, like, at low levels it is definitely grinding until, like, the time that you're rich enough, but... once you do get rich enough, it's like just such a rewarding experience. So let's get back to the entrance. Unless we check this place. Ah! Which goes, ah! Might as well, right? I mean, I think the devs planned to place this level at the beginning. Because, I mean, Stonekeep was so much more difficult than this is. But then again, I mean, I guess a huge part of that is because of the huge AR boost and all the experience that I have right now. Like, all my stats boosts and stuff. But, yeah. Stonekeep felt much harder than this. But I guess this would have felt just as hard back then as well. So, just as difficult back then as well. So, I guess I can't really... say that, but yeah.